Memorial Hall, this historic building is the site for tonight's fights. It is time for our co-main event. It's scheduled for 10 rounds. Sharif Bulgari taking on Fernando Garcia. Bully, let's get to the tail of the tape. What numbers are salient to you?
Well, you see Garcia has a much bigger reach advantage at 72 inches to Bulgari, 68 inches. So we'll see if he can impose that reach advantage. The rest of the stuff is pretty even on paper as far as the age, height, weight, and so forth. Bulgari is obviously the more heralded prospect. We'll see if he can continue the momentum he's built up after losing a world title shot to Rashad Brill not that long ago.
Well, there is Fernando Garcia. Comes out of Tijuana. And there is Sharif, calls himself the Lion. Both men are in the ring. Let's get the official introduction. Here's Joe Martinez.
And all five fans, we are set to go with the next bout tonight. 10 rounds, this scheduled in the junior welterweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks trimmed in silver, he weighed at officially 136 pounds. This veteran brings a professional record that stands at 30 victories, 6 defeats, 2 draws with 19 big wins coming by way of knockout, presentando el hijo de Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico, Fernando Cuervito Garcia! And next his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks trimmed in gold, he weighed in also 136 pounds. A 26-fight veteran, he brings 25 victories. Just one defeat with 17 knockout victories to his credit. From Las Vegas, Nevada, originally from Uganda, here is the former NABO lightweight champion, Sharif the Lion Bulgari! Referee in charge, Mike Marvell.
All right, gentlemen, we went over the instructions. These trunks are good right here. This red belt line is going to be okay. It stays right there. Touch them up, come out boxing.
Sharif Bulgari, originally from Uganda, now fighting and living out of Las Vegas. And Fernando Garcia. Bulgari said he took 6 weeks he trained for this fight. He's on a two-fight win streak. This is round one. It's scheduled for 10. Gary in those black trunks with the gold trim, and he comes out. Two-punch combination to Garcia.
Nice little short hook by Bulgari off that jab. Pulls himself right away. He's got two stoppage wins since the loss on points in a world title shot to Rashad Brill. And that's been his only loss as a professional thus far. So, you know, he's dropped the level of opposition since that fight a little bit. Fernando Garcia is along those lines as well, maybe just a little below world class, but Bulgari continues to dominate the way he has his last two fights. He'll show that he belongs at a world class level, and he'll show that he's deserving of a title shot. So that's pretty much what we're looking to see here, if Bulgari can continue to dominate this level and warrant the step up that he so much craves, and now the shot at a world title.
There's another short left hook. Bulgari, he definitely says he wants to fight for the title by next year. Another crack at it. You can see he's got quick hands.
Quick hands, is pretty alert defensively thus far. Garcia out of bed fighter himself, keeping the punches short.
The third time Garcia has fought here in the States. He's won one, he's lost one. For him, fighting out of most of his fights out of Mexico. And then Tijuana, he says, obviously he loves coming here for the money. But he says, I love showing the American fight fans that I'm a warrior.
And Bulgari taking his time with the jab. Real sharp with it thus far in the first round.
short left hook by Garcia.
I like the way Bulgari's mixing the jab. He's going upstairs with it, downstairs with it. Sometimes he's turning it into a left hook, and it sets up right hands like that.
Yeah, it was a straight right hand he connected with.
Nice little step over. Bulgari showing some good wrinkles here in round one.
One of the things he said he worked on in this camp is his movement, stepping around his man, and another left hook.
Nice
round one
feint.
Comes to a close. Bulgari catches him with a left hook.
Yep.
That one rocked Garcia. Body shots now, Bulgari. Another left hook. At the close of this round. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team, that little devil herself, Jessica Gonzalez.
Thanks, Brian. Now, making his return to the ring tonight, Danny O'Connor. You retired, haven't boxed in about a year. What will we see tonight?
I'm looking to put on a good show in front of all my fans. It's great to be back, first of all, but it's even better to be back in front of a home crowd and all the fans that have supported me my whole career. So I'm blessed to be here, and I'm happy to put on a show for everyone.
And now the real question is the passion still there? Is the fire still in you? What is different this second time around?
Boxing is just a sport. At the end of the day, I'm going to go home to my wife and my son, and they're going to love me the same. So I'm out here tonight to have fun. The excitement is back. That's what I've been missing for a long time, and the excitement's back, and I'm excited to be here and fight. I'm nervous. I got some anxiety, but it's all good emotions that I'm experiencing. So I'm just happy to be back in the ring.
All right. Sounds good, Danny. We're going to send it back to you guys.
All right, Jessica, Danny, thank you very much. Of course, he's our main event. You will see him taking on Andrew Farmer. This is our co-main, Sharif Bogare. Taking on Fernando Garcia. Sharif went right to work. Really had Garcia in trouble at the end of the first round. Here's another left hook,
right,
and that drops Garcia.
Pick it up right where he left off.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And Sharif, there he's going right after him. Another left hook connects. The Lion, as he calls himself, is certainly on the prowl.
You know what, one thing is impressive about Bogare, he's not getting wild. You know, he's keeping his punches short, making sure he's punching from a proper distance, even though when he does land good shots, it hurts his man. He hasn't gotten crazy, and then you like to see that. He's being a veteran in there. Garcia has that Mexican warrior spirit, man. He's still fighting.
Yeah, he's still on the come forward. Double jab, right hand by Sharif. Uppercut by Garcia.
I love to see that. Garcia undaunted. He had a tough first round. He's been down in the second round, but Garcia's still a lot of fight in him.
90 seconds left here in round two. There's another right hand. Short left hook.
Off that feint of a jab. Again off the feint. I like the way Bulgari's been feinting a lot tonight. He's really set up his offense well and keeps him sharp. Keeps him in that rhythm.
There's a body shot. Another right hand. Garcia loses his balance. Forty seconds here left in round two. Gary's got 17 knockouts, along with his 25 wins. 11 of those have come in the first and second round. Garcia connects. Comes the final seconds here of round two. Right hand. And Garcia caps it with the left hook.
look at the knockdown in the last round. As Wolgray had a great cap off to the end of the first round, and then follows it up with some momentum in the second round. A short little combination. I don't know if Garcia was fully recovered yet from the end of the first round punches that he took, and he went down. But to Garcia's credit, he came back fighting.
Yeah, you know, Garcia said his game plan here, apply some pressure. Well, Gary, use that uppercut. We did see that one uppercut. He did connect in that second round.
Yeah, he's not shy about letting the offense go. He's not getting frustrated in that way.
Talking about letting the offense go. Well, Gary let it go there.
A lot of times when a guy like Bulgaray with these fast hands and sharp punches starts landing, you know, a lot of times the opponent will get, wouldn't say complacent, but more unsure of himself and maybe not let go of his hands as much as he should. But Garcia hasn't shown that as of yet. You know, he still has that fighting spirit regardless of maybe not having the same kind of ammunition that Bulgaray has.
Body shots. Oh, a left uppercut by Bulgaria, and then he caps it off with a jab. Garcia, you just said, come on, bring it.
That's what I mean about the ammunition of Bulgaria. Went to the body with a couple of shots and came up with a left uppercut. Good variation of the offense. Tough to time a guy like that. Time tough to know what's coming at your way when a guy can vary that way. And most of defense is anticipation. When you can't anticipate the guy's offense as Bulgaria's mixing up well, it's tough to make him miss.
He was captain of the Ugandan national team. He was a five-time African champion as an amateur. Left Uganda during the 2007 World Amateur Boxing Championships in Chicago. Now resides in Las Vegas. There's a body shot. Garcia comes back with a stiff jab.
Good catch and shoot, left uppercut on the inside there from Bulgaria as well. Stepping around a lot to that right side. Seems like something, you know, they talked about the stepovers there, the left hook. Talked about the stepovers that they worked on in the gym with Kenny Adams. He's been doing a lot of that.
Left hook connects. Under 30 seconds now. There's the step around, as you talked about, Paulie.
It's working well. Garcia has been confused by it each time. And it's opened up a new punch angle each time. So unless Garcia adjusts to it, you know, it's going to keep working for him.
Oh, my goodness. Body. Head shots.
There's some action from that last round as Bulgaria on the inside and a wicked left hook.
Well, Bulgaria certainly dominated this fight thus far with his offense. He did drop Garcia in the second round. Faints and then throws a jab. Punch combination there by Bulgaria.
Good speed, good sense of timing, punching from proper distance. Clinical performance from Bulgaria.
Everything has been off that jab. He's gone to the body and head, Garcia. You mentioned Gary's last loss came in March of last year. Shara Brill lost that WBA lightweight title fight to him. Well, Gary admits he said he hurt his ankle in the fifth round of that fight.
Yeah, sometimes you got to fight through that. He went the distance in the fight regardless, and it was a pretty competitive fight nonetheless. So, well, Gary's right there. He's been on the cusp. You know, he wants to get back up there.
He took him a year, he said, to really rehab that ankle. Another three-punch combination by Bulgari.
Again, those step arounds always to the right. Garcia should be making an adjustment at this point, because anytime Bulgari steps around, it's always to his right.
Oh,
good body
left
shot
to the body. And a right to the body. Left hook by Bulgari. And Garcia still throwing.
They're gonna flash their heads there too.
Now, Bulgari going to that body of Garcia. Straight right hand. Uppercut.
Garcia's trying to fight, but it's Bulgari pulls the trigger first every time.
Yeah.
For starters, Garcia should try to be first a lot of times, man, because and there he was. There, see what happens. He was first. He put Bulgari on the defensive, but most of the time it's bingo, but Bulgari being first.
The left hook gets in by Garcia. This has been another round dominated by Sharif Bulgari as he steps around and caps it with a right hand. Welcome back. You're watching Golden Boy Live here on Fox Sports 1. Sharif Bulgari taking on Fernando Garcia. This is round 5. At Memorial Hall here in Plymouth, Massachusetts, I'm Brian Custer alongside Paulie Malignaggi. Bulgari dropped Garcia at the beginning of the second round. Has really dominated. Now at this point, you talking to Sharif about finishing in the corner?
I think he's got an opportunity to get a finish, but Garcia's pretty durable. He's pretty sturdy. You know, he's been hurt, but hasn't been hurt in a way where, you know, he could have been knocked out thus far. So I think Bulgari's being patient yet aggressive, if you can really put those two adjectives together. And he's trying to maybe pick his spot to see if there is a moment where he can pounce and get a stoppage.
Last time Garcia was stopped, it was in March of last year.
I do like to see that he doesn't abandon the fundamentals regardless. You know, in a fight he's dominating, he still remembers to work off the jab and use those little feints and use those step arounds. It's the little intangibles that you're not quick to pay attention to. He's able to slip.
Bulgari has stopped his last two opponents. There's a left hook.
That's been a lot of times this fight where Garcia tries to come with that left uppercut, but he gets met with a left hook from Bulgari. I don't know that he's timing it very well, or that maybe Bulgari's timing him well instead.
Three punch combination by Bulgari. For more on him, let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Jessica Rosales.
So Bulgari's corner told me that there are three things that really stand out tonight: the way that he's utilizing his jab, working the body, and he's using those leaping hooks. Now, they did say Garcia, they knew he would be durable and tough, but Bulgari's corner did tell me that they don't see this going past the sixth round.
Oh, well, we're under a minute here in the fifth. There's another right hand.
And I was going to say, that's actually key number 4 right there we've seen tonight. A lot of times, Bulgari's actually doubled up those right hands a lot.
Where's that left right hand that drops Garcia?
Speaking of right hands.
And that's it. Jessica Gonzalez was right on it. She said his corner didn't see it going past six. It didn't go past five.
Yeah, well, Kenny Adams is, I guess, more prophetic, right, in the Bulgari corner.
Masterful display there by Sharif Bulgari. He drops Hernando Garcia here in the fifth round and stops him.
We get some looks at the final display and the stoppage, and there's that sharp 1-2. And you see Bulgari, y'all changing the look, changing his level. He starts out from down low. It's kind of a little faint, and then comes up with a sharp 1-2 with a lot of weight behind it. So we're gonna watch the feint first. He drops down, but Garcia might think he's going to the body. Then he comes up with a 1-2 to the head before Garcia could readjust the fact that maybe Bulgari is not gonna go to the body. See again right here. Garcia almost braces for what might be a body attack. Instead, Bulgari pops right up and shoots a sharp 1-2 before Garcia can readjust. Never does get to adjust it as he goes down instead.
We're gonna take a short break. When we come back, the official time of this stoppage. You're watching Golden Boy Live here on Fox Sports 1. You're watching Golden Boy Live here on Fox Sports 1. We're in Plymouth, Massachusetts. As Sharif Bulgari taking on Fernando Garcia.
Yeah, and you see Bulgari, the story of the fight was really Bulgari's speed, the sharper offense. We saw the end of the first round with a sharp combination. And early in the second round, the knockdown. Get the same consistency from Bulgari, and that was a lot of what we saw. And there's finally that sharp 1-2 that dropped Garcia, stayed down for the count. As you can see, he's not totally out cold. I think maybe it wasn't that particular punch that knocked him out, but it was the ferocity of that right hand, plus the fact that he'd been getting beat up all night, made him say, you know what, I think I've had enough. I think I'm done for tonight.
Yeah, you take a look at the final punch stat there. Bulgari landed nearly 200 punches. Garcia, barely 40. Let's get the official time here of this stoppage. Here's Joe Martinez.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes at the official time. 2:10, round number 5. Referee Mike Marvell reaches a count of 10 for your winner by KO victory, Sharif the Lion Bulgari.
Well, the Lion certainly roared tonight. He knocks out Fernando Garcia, says he wants to fight for a title next year.
Well, I think he made a good statement tonight.
Well, we got some bonus coverage coming up here. Mark DeLuca, Ryan Davis, it's next on Golden Boy Live here on Fox Sports 1.